Hello all, Aseo Noctum here with another Guild Wars 2 lore video. Today I'm going to cover the Plains of Ashford. That is the Char starting zone and the zone located right outside of the Black Citadel. This is a really cool zone for Guild Wars 1 veterans because there's a lot of backstory here. I wish they put more of that story into Guild Wars 2 or that they at least didn't hide it as well as they do. But I'm going to try to bring some of that to the forefront for you. Plains of Ashford is named for the original pre-searing town of Ashford in Guild Wars 1. You went there straight out of the tutorial area. Pretty much anyone that's played Guild Wars 1 must have at least passed through Ashford in the early stages of the game. It's right outside of the Ashford Abbey. It was just a small farming town. Nowadays, though, it's primarily under the control of the Iron Legion. In the northwest portion of the map, right when you come out of Black Citadel and where you're going to start if you just started a new Char character, you're going to notice that there's a really heavy emphasis on building and maintaining the Iron Legion weaponry. You're also going to notice that there seem to be a lot of cubs running around. This is because Char society is a little different than human society. At the age of one, cubs leave their families and enter into a Afara. Afara is pretty much their equivalent to school. It's where they gain all of their combat and survival training and where they form their war bands. I suspect that they do the bulk of their training here in the northwest part of the map because it's really the safest area, but it still gives them the opportunity to run into enemies to hone their combat skills, because there is a pretty heavy problem with Flame Legion in the area. You see that they're constantly just messing with the Iron Legion, stealing weaponry, stealing materials. And for those of you that don't know, the Flame Legion is the only legion that isn't part of the rest of the Char. They're not welcome in the Black Citadel. The other three legions distrust them. They were really what led to the searing in Guild Wars 1. You're also going to notice in this northwest corner, and actually throughout all of the Char zones, that their heavy industrialization has led to a lot of pollution. It's most noticeable in the waterways and lakes. There are tar elementals just about any place that you find water around any Char settlement. And a lot of the hearts have to do with trying to clean that up. Probably one of the most fun spots on this part of the map, however, is the little bit involving the devourers. You get to help some cubs harvest devourer eggs. It's a neat little event. It's not part of a heart, so it's pretty easy to overlook, but the event does run pretty often. But devourers are pretty important to the Char. They take them as eggs, raise them as their combat companions, pretty much. You're also going to find, right outside of the walled portion of the northwest corner, the old Duke's Estate. This used to be the famous vineyards and estates of Duke Barrowden. He was a human noble of Ascalon who did die during the Foe Fire. He is the final boss of the Char tutorial, and it's here that you learn, if you didn't read the books, that the ghosts can never really be gotten rid of. You can kill a ghost, but you're really just dispersing them temporarily. They always come back, and that's most noticeable here in the old Duke's Estate, because sure enough, Duke Barrowden does come back. He's part of a dynamic event that pops up. It's a really cool little area, but it is pretty difficult. I wouldn't recommend heading in to the underground portion of it on your own if you're of the appropriate level for the zone. It's pretty challenging. It's even a little challenging on a level 80. If you head down south from the estate, you're going to run into an Ash Legion encampment. And you can talk to the soldiers here and you'll find out that they're tracking the ghosts and preparing supplies for the other legions. They're very interested in clearing out the Decima stones. There's not a whole lot of lore about what the stones are, but you can go through there. There is a splendid chest at the end of the area. and it appears to have been an old human cemetery. Now, it's a pretty big cemetery, so I can't help but think that there must be some pretty influential people that were buried there. But like I said, I wasn't able to find any backstory for the area, unfortunately. Now, the most notable part of the zone is going to be the northern border. This is the toppled wall. It has a ton of significance for Guild Wars 1 veterans. This is the location of the original Northern Wall. Now, the Northern Wall was built by the humans of Ascalon back during, well before Guild Wars 1 times. The Northern Wall was constructed to prevent the Char from coming into Ascalon City, and it held them back very well up until the Searing. The Searing allowed the Char to raise Ascalon City without crossing the wall, and this led to not entirely the destruction of the wall, but definitely the neglect and ruination of it. Nowadays, it seems to be the home to a large harpy population. On this side of the toppled wall, you're going to find the Agnos Gorge. This is a pretty interesting area because it shows one of the few remaining crystals from the Searing, and it's a huge crystal. You really can't miss it. It's a point of interest. Once again, not a whole lot of story there with it, but it's still really neat to see, especially if you are a Guild Wars 1 veteran and you played through all the events for the Searing. Just south of the map, you're going to come to the Abbey Ruins. This is another neat little spot for veterans. It's the remains of the Ashford Abbey. The entrance to the old catacombs is here, but the bulk of it's been blocked off. You can't get under there. It'd be kind of neat if they do eventually open it up, but I'd be pretty surprised. They don't really seem to be doing much of anything with it right now. You're also going to find the Ashford Forum, which is a Char settlement, and it's based primarily around the nearby fighting pit. It's one of their biggest bases in the Plains of Ashford, and they're under pretty constant attack from the Flame Legion. There's a very strong presence here in the southern part of the map. They're all kind of holed up in a cave to the south of Ashford Forum. It's not really clear why they're in that particular area, but that seems to be their main hideout in the map. Another really interesting part of this zone is, of course, the ruins of Ascalon City. That's in the northeast part of the map. I believe there's a big meta event that takes place there. This, of course, is the former location of Ascalon City. It was left in ruins after the Searing. A small group of forces remained behind after the Searing, and they were led by King Adelburn. Now, for those of you that played Guild Wars 1, you're probably very familiar with the story, but nonetheless, they held Ascalon City for 20 years. They were dying out, having trouble getting supplies and whatnot, and as a last-ditch effort, Adelburn used his famous sword Magdaer and cause the Foe Fire. There are conflicting stories as to how exactly the Foe Fire came about. The humans claim that it happened when Adelburn used his sword and it came in contact with the Char Claw of Conur, that the clashing of the two caused a spark which caused the Foe Fire. The Char, however, say that that is not what happened, that Adelburn, in a moment of insanity, thrust his sword into the ground and called upon its full power, condemning his own people to an eternity of afterlife as a ghost, and killing off all of the Char in the city. It's not clear as to which story is actually true or not, though the bulk of the NPCs in Guild Wars 2 lean more towards the Char version being correct. But regardless, the effect was the same. All of the Char in the city were killed, and all of the humans in Ascalon, excluding Ebonhawk, were turned into ghosts, and those are the ghosts that you see and fight today. The ghosts are completely irrational. They are frozen in time. Everyone they see as an enemy char. It doesn't matter what your race is, you appear as a char to them, and that's why they will attack anyone that comes into their territory. To the southeast of the Ascalon City ruins, you're going to come upon the Kadam Forest. You have a different set of problems here. You actually have an ogre infestation. The furthest ogre encampment to the east is at Stonecrog Crawl. It's unclear as to why the ogres have come into Plains of Ashford. I assume it's just the result of them seeking out more territory from Blaze Ridge Steppes. But they are a pretty minor threat. They're only in that one area. And further south from that, you come upon the Loreclaw Expanse. There is a pretty heavy separatist population here. I suspect that these separatists are coming in from the Fields of Ruin because of its location on the map, and there is a huge separatist standing in the Fields of Ruin from Ebonhawk. But they're clearly trying to get a hold in the Plains of Ashford to push through. And that's pretty much the basis of what's going on in the Plains of Ashford. So if you found this video useful or just enjoyed watching it, please remember to like it and subscribe to my channel. There will be lots more videos to come. Thanks for watching!